Now in the second theorem, which is also related to angles and side, the second theorem states that if two sides of triangle are unequal, then the greater side has a greater angle opposite to it. For this theorem, we'll consider this figure, figure number 2. So I'll again state the theorem. It's in this triangle XYZ of figure 2, it's very clear that XZ is a smaller side and XY is a smaller side and XZ is a greater side. So according to the theorem, that the angle opposite to the greater side is greater than the angle opposite to shorter side. So the angle which is opposite to this side, that means this complete angle, angle Y, should be greater than the angle opposite to the shorter side, that means this angle. So we have to prove that angle Y is greater than angle Z. And for to prove this, we have done the construction. We have drawn a line segment YM such that XM is equal to XY. So let's start the proof. Before that, let us write the construction. This is theorem number 2. So the construction is, draw YM such that XY is equal to XM. Draw YM such that XY is equal to XM. That's why I have marked this blue mark on both these sides to specify that this line is equal to this line XM. Now, what do we need to prove? We need to prove that this angle Y is greater than this angle Z. So angle Y is greater than angle Z. When I say angle Y, I mean the complete angle Y of the triangle XYZ. So this complete angle. To prove that angle Y is greater than angle Z. And what is given to us? Given. First thing that is given is XY is equal to XM. XY is equal to XM. And second thing is that XY is less than XZ. XY is the shorter side. XY is less than XZ. This is the information which is given to us. Now let us start the proof. Now, as you know from the theorem 1, if two sides of a triangle are equal, that means the angle opposite to them is also equal. In this triangle XYM, these two sides are equal. That means angle opposite to them should also be equal. So this angle XYM and XMY are equal by theorem 1. So I'll write that angle XYM is equal to angle XMY. By theorem 1. Right? So we have proved that both of these angles are equal. Now, if you see this triangle YMZ, this lower triangle, then this angle XMY is the exterior angle of the lower triangle, right? And there is a property which says that the exterior angle is equal to the sum of interior opposite angles. For example, this angle is equal to the sum of these two angles, MYZ and MZY. Because if you say, if let us consider that this angle is equal to X degree, if I say that this angle is equal to X degree, then this angle will be equal to 180 minus X, because both are linear pair and angle on a straight line is equal to 180 degree. So if this is X degree, then this angle is equal to 180 minus X. Correct? if this is x, this is 180 minus x, and you know that the sum of all the angles in a triangle is equal to 180 degree. That means this plus this angle plus this angle is equal to 180 degree. When will be the sum of all these three angles equal to 180 degree? When the sum of both these angles is equal to x. When sum of both these angles is equal to x and it is added to 180 minus x, then 180 minus x plus x is equal to 180. That means the sum of both these interior angles is equal to the exterior angle of a triangle. So that means this angle, this exterior angle is greater than these individual angles, correct? Because by joining them we get this angle. So that means this angle is greater than both these angles. So I can write the angle XMY, angle XMY, this angle which is the exterior angle. Let me first write the triangle we are considering. We are considering the triangle YMZ, the lower triangle. In triangle YMZ, the angle XMY, which is the exterior angle XMY, is greater than this angle which is MZY. Because this is an exterior angle and this is the interior opposite angle of that triangle. So it will, the exterior angle will always be greater than this angle. So I have proved that XMY is greater than MZY. Now I know that XMY is equal to XYM. So I can say that if this is possible, then I can say that angle XYM is also greater than angle MZY. Correct? That means XYM, this angle which I have marked with a blue color, is greater than this angle MZY. Right? Now if this angle is greater than this angle, then it obviously means that this complete angle will be greater than this angle, because this complete angle Y is made up of this component and this component. If this component is greater than this, this obviously means that the whole of the angle Y is greater than angle Z, because angle Y is equal to angle XYM plus XYM plus MYZ plus angle MYZ. Now, if XYM is greater than MZY, then it obviously means that this whole angle is greater than MZY. So I can say that angle Y, the complete angle of the triangle XYZ is greater than angle MZY. Hence we have proved that, hence we have proved that the angle which is opposite to the greater side, for example, this was the angle which was opposite to the greater side out of these two sides. Now this was the angle which was opposite to the greater side and this was the angle which was opposite to the smaller side, and we have proved that the angle opposite to the greater side is always greater than the angle opposite to the smaller side. And also the converse of this theorem is true. The converse says that if two angles are unequal to each other, then the side opposite to the greater angle is greater than the side opposite to the smaller angle. For example, if I know that this whole angle is greater, then I can say that this angle, that the side opposite to this angle, that means this whole side XZ, is greater than the side opposite to this smaller angle XY.